What's going on YouTube? Drama D here. Gonna go ahead and give you guys a weekly update. The last couple weeks, 3-4 weeks, I've really been finding myself getting more and more involved back into the hobby. I mean, I've always had tanks, I've always done stuff, but the last couple weeks I've just been spending money on corals and tanks and really getting after it. Trying to create something beautiful in my house and something to share with everyone. My ups and downs, goods and bads. So let's just get into it. Try not to drag this video out too long. I'm already rambling. So before we get to the tank, for anyone that hasn't seen, this is the new tank for the frilled lizard that my wife rescued. Just for shits and giggles, excuse my language. Let's look at his old tank. So this is his old tank. Fake background, like sand and a old broomstick. So let's go look back at the other tank real quick. Okay, we're back here at the other tank. As you can see, we are not finished creating this tank, but this is as far as we got. Don't want to dump too much money into it all at once. But we basically use some cork bark, real plants, fake plants, some moss, different types of moss. Some forest bedding. Our plan is for this corner over here where the water dish is to have a waterfall coming down, and then cover the rest of the back with like a cork bark wall, maybe a little bit on the side. But the lizard seems to be loving it. It took them a while to adjust, and now that he has adjusted, he seems to be enjoying the new tank. He is a lot more active. I guess in his old tank, the previous owner said that he never moved. He stayed on the one broomstick branch every day, all day for 5 years. Right now he's basking. I got the basking light on. I need to mist the cage down, bring the humidity up to about 70. But the plans for a waterfall and a fogger is in the works, and hopefully that will help maintain the humidity, especially here in these summer months to come. So moving on from that, I got my quarantine tank still over here. This is a no chemical quarantine, no copper, none of that. It's a hyposalinity tank. I have some rock from my old system in there. There was aptasia stuff on there. I threw some berguys in there and they have cleaned it all up, and I'm happy to say that it's all gone. As far as the queen conch, I thought that bad boy was a goner, but nope, he was just pissed off, I guess. He's still alive. So, great surprise, and I'm happy to see that. Some other stuff that's going on with the tank is, as you can see here, I got some new salt that I'm trying out, and so far I love it. The corals are responding super awesome compared to the natural seawater that I was getting from Scripps. The reason why I chose to stray away from Scripps is I believe that was my source of the dino outbreak, and when I had my 150 I had reoccurring cyano that would pop its head up like once every month and a half or 2 months. You know, small outbreaks, but still a pain in the butt to take care of. The last thing I want to do is run Kimmy Clean or something like that on my system. I really don't like adding chemicals to the tank. I'd rather try to kick it in the butt naturally with water changes, removal, you know, adding like nurturing bacteria such as these two. I am really happy with the results of the Dr. Tim's Refresh Waste Away program. As long as you start out with the half dose and slowly ramp your way up every other day, you know, to start, and then once the system has been acclimated to the first 1 week of dosing of the refresh and 1 week of dosing of Waste Away, then you can go to a monthly dosing program. I would still recommend, if only doing monthly, to do a half dose, or maybe just a little more than half. I wouldn't do a full dose, especially after not dosing it for a while. But so far, there's the schedule that I've done, and I did two back-to-back doses of the Refresh and Waste Away. The Dinos were gone. They showed up one day out of the blue again and tried to get crazy out of control, and I went ahead and did another back-to-back week of this, and it kicked it in the butt immediately. So the Refresh is a nitrifying bacteria, and the Waste Away is a different type of bacteria. But I find that the Waste Away needs the nurturing bacteria to feed off of to break down some of that gunk that builds up on the rocks. Why the gunk is in there in the first place, I'm going to blame it on the Scripps natural seawater that I was using, the fact that I used dry rock. I soaked it for a month in a trash can. But I just felt like maybe it was releasing some stuff that was trapped in, you know, dry rock sometimes takes 6 months to a year of leaching just organics out of it, you know, die off. But I'm not going to get into all that. I'm not a scientist. I'm not a know-it-all. I'm not claiming to know it all. I'm just trying to share my experience with you guys. I've used dry rock in the past, and this is the first time that I've really had some issues from the get-go with Dino. So the X1 there is going to be used in conjunction with these 2,000 milliliter flasks. You can see I got the little rigid tubing. Going to try to make a caulk reactor using a Hanna stirrer. One of these bottles will sit on the stirrer with a little pill inside. It'll kick on 7 times a day. And then the the dosing pump will suck out of this one, which will in turn suck out of the, sorry, bad filling. I was zoomed in. But anyways, the dosing pump will suck out of this one, and this one will be connected to the one with the caulk in it. This will have RO, this will have the caulk. So I'm going to suck out of this one, probably, 10 minutes after the stir time, let it settle. So it'll suck out of this one, and this one will suck out of that one, just to make sure I don't get any clumps or anything like that. These things up here will have some rubber stoppers on here with holes that these will go down into, creating a airtight seal. Like I said, the Hanna stirrer will be on a timer. Stir up 7 times a day. I'm not going to do a full saturated caulk. I'm going to do probably like a quarter. I still need to figure out the dosing. Like I said, I've never ran caulkwasser. I am still dosing the Bionic 2-part along with some magnesium from the local fish store. It's their blend. And dosing very minimal amounts. I'm dosing 5 mils of each a day. Per day, and I'm maintaining a level of, I think I tested last week and I was at 8.6 alkalinity, bumping up from 8.3, and I blame that on, I did a water change with that, and that mixes at 8.0, mixed at 1.026, so I dosed 5 mils to 4.5 gallons, and it brought the alkalinity up to 8.6. Previously I was between 8.1 and 8.4-ish, you know, all in between that range. Usually very, very steady, just dosing 5 mils a day. But anyways, I want to try to maybe see if I could create some type of caulkwasser reactor. The only thing that's kind of steering me away from even wanting to try it is the pH. You know, as I have a naturally high pH current system. Here I am rambling again. Got the coral view lens on right now. Let's just go ahead and look at the tank. So here's the tank. Very small amount of dinos in there. Let's go ahead and get a close-up, show you some of the, let's just do a coral walkthrough real quick. Right here in the center, I got the Fungia plate. It's green, got a bright green mouth. This thing is massive. It's about 6 inches across. As you can see right behind it there, that is a new pickup. Thanks Danny. It's orange, Fungia plate. If you notice the rim on it, let me see if I could zoom in a little bit. It's got kind of a gold rim, and the little feelers coming out are like a maroon, dark maroon red. It's got like rainbow colors, man. It's kind of not picking it up. But I was chilling at Danny's house last night, and Hector was over there. What's up, Hector? Great guy. Nano Reef. He's got some awesome tanks. He's got a YouTube channel. You guys go check him out. His old lagoon kind of inspired me to actually get this lagoon tank. So thank you, Hector. He pointed out this plate. I didn't notice the gold rim on it until he noticed it. And we started talking about pricing, and I said, you know what, I thought he was going to pick that one, and he picked this smaller one with white streaks in it. And I decided, you know what, if you don't want it, I'll take it. But I want to get rid of this big green plate because it is taking up some real estate in the tank. So moving on, let's just do a quick walkthrough so that's way I'm not blabbering too much. I got the jawbreaker here. As you can see, it's got a little bit of dinos that we're trying to grow on the plate. I'm still brushing the rocks off and getting it up in the column, doing the waste away refresh program. I'm on the final days of the second week program. Rambling again, sorry guys. Here we got some Bowsers. If they're not Bowsers, let me know. I'm pretty sure they're Bowsers. And then right here next to them, let's see if I could zoom in a little bit, focus. Those are some speckled cracks. Got a few babies popping up on the bottom already. Sorry about the shakiness. I don't have the tripod out. So another new addition are these big bad boys right here. These are the rainbow hornets. Very beautiful. Took them a couple days to open up because I noticed there was some hair algae all in between them. So I just took the whole plug and actually did a pure hydrogen peroxide dip for 2 minutes. And they were all pissed off. You know, I had bubbles on them. I had to rinse them off in some fresh salt mix. And here they are 2 days later, doing well. This one right here that's not open, pretty much that last big Zoa order I got, this guy opened up like twice, and then I moved him to the middle over there where the magicians are, and excuse me, I got hair in my throat or something. Angry Al. Anyways, I put them back there where the magicians were, and it just never opened up. I noticed some algae around it, so I gave it a little toothbrush scrubbing. It started to open up, and then I decided, you know, I want to kind of keep all the pallies over there in this area, like a little pally garden, little mixture. Hopefully they don't overtake one another, but they probably will. But anyway, so I took this plug off where the magicians were, and I gave him a iodide dip, and as you can see, he is starting to try to open. I seen him open yesterday. It's still early in the morning. The lights have been on for about 2 hours, so it's still ramping up. I have so many hermit crabs in here, they just clomp over everything. I'm thinking about whittling down some of the hermits and maybe getting some different types of truncus snails, or you know, Florida surfs or dwarf surfs or something. Maybe thin out some of the hermits and switch over to a snail, even though the snails will climb over everything. I do like the hermits. They're a good cleanup crew for any waste that, you know, and food that doesn't get eaten by the fish, or you know, the coral shit. Like, I made a video last week and I erased it because I went on a ramble about the drama in the YouTube community and the reefing community. So I just decided, you know, I need to just keep my thoughts and opinions to myself and just do me and don't worry about other people. But let's stop rambling. Let's get in. We got the pink and gold back there. Those orange ones, those are the tangerine dreams. Down there, those, I believe, are red hornets. Got the purple monsters. Got the Yacan. Like I said, it's still ramping up. He probably grows out to this plate down here when he puffs up. Right here, there's some more hornets. Not sure which ones. They got the gold ring inside, maybe the blue hornets. Some more pink and golds. That little one dead center, that's like a stargazer or something like that. Bear with me, guys. I'm kind of horrible on Zoa names. Like I said, I've kept Zoas in the past and was pretty much unsuccessful. I was able to keep them for 2 to 3 months, and then eventually they just melted away. Seeing so many people's tanks, a couple in particular, Calypso, Hector, they have some beautiful Zoa collections and lots of pop, Drew's Lagoon. And it kind of inspired me and made me want to challenge myself to try to keep a variety of Zoas and see if I can get a nice colorful Zoa rock. I don't know, this tank, I had plans for it, but all my plans have kind of gone away, and we're going with this softy LPS tank, maybe a few choice SPS mixed reef, but I, for the most part, I want to keep it LPS and softies. But you know, there will be a few SPS in here. But here I am rambling again. We got some Bam Bams moving up. We got some Rosses. As you can see, there's some new babies on there. Of course, they are glued in a way where you can't see the nice big polyps on the other side, but there is some babies popping up. These Nirvanas were actually double in size, but there was a nice orange Inferno Acan right there, right below the Gatorades. And it like overgrew them and killed it. And I was telling myself I need to move it, relocate it. And I was too late, so I had to pull, I just pulled the Acan off and I kind of ripped some of the Zoa skin. So it's kind of recovering. But those have grown the fastest in the tank. The one that's not open right there, I think it's maybe a pink diamond or something. Got the rainbow Acan. You know, since switching the color, or switching the salts, the color has since returned. It was starting to dull out, starting to get its red and color pop back. So I don't know, if it's, I haven't really done much to the lighting. I did change to a little bit more icy blue and switched around the intensities by 5%, ramping up and down, and maybe that had something to do with it. But I think a lot of it had to do with the salt. This is another Acan. He kept getting flipped over, tossed around, moved around. I ended up taking a disc and just gluing him to the disc and moving him over here, and he seems to be much happier than he has been. This piece, when it was not getting flipped over daily, was looking really nice. So I'm hoping it gets fat like this one. Moving up, those are the Goblins on Fire. Looks like they just got walked over by some type of hermit. If look at my rocks, you can see the dry rock. I'm starting to get all types of coralline algae growth all over the rocks, all over the tank, which is a great sign. Coming up here, you got that one zoa by itself. It looks like maybe a couple might have melted off there. No idea, not sure if they're getting trampled on, but boo-hoo. Up here, those are either pink diamonds or, shoot, dude, something. Like I said, I'm bad with names. I think these are the fire and ice. Up here, these things, I forget the names of them, but they are beautiful. I love them. Love the color. I can really see them. It's weird. I can see them from the front. Let's see if I can focus on that one. See that guy on the left. I don't know. I really like that piece. There's another A-can. See the rock there? It's got the coralline popping all over it. Great sign. These ones up here, below that A-can, shaky camera, or the Fruit Loops, I believe. Scrolling across, got the utter chaos, couple polyps just got trampled on. Up here, like rainbow infusions and incinerators. They're still getting trampled on. Right here is the scrambled eggs. You see a weird little green morph coming out. I think there's some more hornets back there. Right there above the scrambled eggs. More like infusions. I think that's another Bowser up there. I didn't realize I had a Bowser and I went and got another one. Let me zoom out. Focus. Some other kind of hornets. Those are the LA Lakers. So then down here, those little green skirt ones are the purple people eaters. Got that A-can looking beautiful. Some more zoas. There's some King Midases, those gold ones. Light's jacking me up on the phone here. I don't know what I just did, but for some reason it doesn't want to focus. Another A-can down here. I don't know what I just did. Jacked up the lighting or some shit on the slider bar. So right there are the red people eaters. I got the nuclear green pallies in the back there. Kind of hard to get a good shot of them. The Captain America pallies, the magicians. So another new piece that I picked up the other day is that right there, I don't know if you can see it. You see some more coralline, but right there you see that little acro. That was the strawberry shortcake from the 150, and I believe it's dead. So I put them in here when the tank first started in hopes that, yeah, you could put acros in on day one. Well, obviously not. Didn't work out for me. Especially through the whole dino outbreak. Coming up here, that is the new piece. It's just a bubblegum digi. Got some nice yellow with blue skin on there. He's been in there for 2 days. Seems to be liking the spot. I know the ugly frag plug, but hopefully it just encrusts over it. I hate trying to take it off and then jam it in the hole, glue it, and then the freaking hermits knock it over. So I just decided to leave it on the plug. This way, if I want to move it, I can just pop the plug off and I can move it as necessary. So over there, there's that peach, pink tip, greenish, yellow endo torch. It's looking good, man. It's getting fat. I think there's another head coming in on it. There's an endo hammer. It's got the gold. It's not really picking up on the camera too well. It's got like gold base. It's kind of showing up like green, but it's like a gold base with the purple tips. On my camera is showing green, but I ensure, or I guarantee it's not. Another new piece is that the guy was saying it's a grafted setosa, but I know it as the Iron Man setosa. It's just basically the red setosa with the streaks of gold going through it. I've had this piece in the past. You know, he's like $5, and I'm like, you know what, I'll throw it in there. I like the colors. Here's a grape coral. Still about the same size. You know, it was doing not so hot, and it was looking better from day to day. The last week or two, it's been consistently looking like that. This rock right here is a rock that we're having the dinos just reappear on. So stuff just leaching out, but now you can see it's starting to get covered in coralline. And a lot of that I chalk it up to the RODI water, the maintaining the alk and calcium levels, the Dr. Tim's nurturing bacteria, eating all that gunk off the rock. There's the tuxedo shrimp. He likes to pick everything up and move it around. Right now he's just got some sand and crap on him. So another new pickup is this yellow endo. It's a yellowish green, but it's an endo octospawn. He just went in last night. This is the first time I'm seeing him starting to open. He gets about maybe double the size that it is. I'm going to try to keep this rock here in the front. Let's see if I could jam 26 minutes. Sorry, guys. Try to keep this rock just maybe those three. I might add one more. He's got a pink hammer branching. It might be a wall hammer. I have to take a look at it again. But I plan to maybe put that one on the other side. I don't know, because the narrow fives there. Maybe I'll put it right here in the front next to the grape. But I just kind of want those to kind of stay there. If I need to, I can always spin that rock around, give this octo a little more light. And so I picked him up last night. He gets about double the size, but you know, he came from a system running 12.6 alk, and my system only runs right now between 8.3 and 8.6, I'd say. I need to test today, so I'll try to test and post the parameters of the tank at the end of the video if I remember to get around to it in time. Like I said, I've got the itch back again. Check out this bad boy. This is a four heads. It's an endo black neon tip torch. To me, this thing was a stunner, man. If you got a real good camera and you can take some macro shots, dude, this thing is killer. But I just kind of didn't know where to put them. I got a small tank, and I decided, just, you know, I'm going to keep this rock in the back right, like maybe surround that thing with torches, get the euphilias over here. I don't want the torches or euphilias getting too close to the zoas. Maybe I'll keep that zoas and acans on the left. That middle one, it's gonna be all pallies around the bottom with some couple more acros in the middle. I need to go talk to Brandon. I'm still not ready for some nice acros yet. I want to wait a couple more months, at least let the system get about 6 months old. And maybe that back rock on the right, maybe throw a couple acros. I might have to move the setosa and the digi to make room. I might get like a mag rock and put it on the back or something and try to make more room. But I want to do like maybe torches all around this bottom right rock. I would love to put a bunch of stuff in here, but you know, it's a small tank, so I don't want these torches to start stretching out and stinging stuff. But as you can see, it is amazing. as far as price, I think he was saying it's like 120 to 200 a head, depending on the coloration. Expensive. This one up here was like 200 a head. So yeah, it's not cheap. Not bragging. The Indo stuff and the Aussie stuff has really gone up in price. Even the fish have gone up in price. I was looking for a Tanaka's pygmy wrasse, and they used to cost about $35. They were about $85, and no one can get them right now. So if you know where I can get a Tanaka's pygmy wrasse, let me know. I might not even get them anymore because I have the geometric perch lead in here. I'm not sure how well they would get along. But the Bangeyes are doing well. Oh yeah, I forgot. There's another piece. It's a Cyphistria. Just a little nub the guy threw in. It wasn't doing too hot. He asked me if I wanted it. I said, sure, why not? So, found that little ledge. Seems to be getting nice light. Seems to like where it's at so far. It was bleached out, so I'm waiting for the colors to come back. It's kind of got the bluish green skin with the red polyps, orangish polyps. Clown's been more active lately. Seems to be getting out of his funk with the loss of his mate. There's a local guy. He has a Wyoming white. I've been thinking about maybe grabbing him up since I have not heard back from the clown breeder Reef Love that I know. Really want to go check out some of her stuff. My buddy Brandon, he picked up some of those mocha. What are the new freaking black storms or whatever? You got the mocha storms, and they are amazing. I was thinking maybe grab a pair of those, and, or just one of them, or a long fin. I don't know. Maybe I'll just get something to pair with the black eyes. He is a black eyes, so. Anyways, I'm rambling. You guys want to see a quick... Since we're in 30 minutes, what's another 5 minutes? If you made it this far, I appreciate you guys watching. If you're skipping ahead, shame on you. Go back and watch this video. No, I'm just kidding. Just cleaned the skimmer last night. After I did some dips, man, this thing went crazy. And it's a good thing I was standing here and heard the lid popping. You know, and the bubbles start coming up. The lid pops up and bounces. I was like, what the heck? And I chop it up to, I dipped one of the corals and I did not rinse it off before I put it in the tank, and it freaking skimmer went crazy. And I just had dosed 3 mils of the peroxide. You know, it was like, I was here till like 1 in the morning geeking out on the tank, dipping and fragging. Anyways, the UV sterilizer's good. Nothing's really changed. I threw a couple more discs in there to get the little slime coat on them so they don't get all... like that when you throw them in the tank. These ones, that one I didn't do it, so I need to go in there, scrub them off. Turkey base the rocks. You can see, I don't know if you guys could pick it up. Those are tons of little pods all over the glass. So no, they are not flatworms.
I remember when I had pods, I thought I had a bunch of pods and they were flat. Now they're not flatworms, dude. I've had flatworms and those suck.
But the sump's a little dirty. I have a batch of water mixed up, but I did do a water change last week. I'm thinking maybe skip this week and I'll do a water change next week. I don't know. I'm just going to see how the tank looks. I don't feel it's necessary to do a water change every week. Doing last week I did 4.5 gallons, so I got another 4.5 gallons of water made in the bucket, and then another 10 gallons just on hand for top off. So maybe I'll do one midweek this coming week, or maybe I'll just wait till next weekend, or maybe I might not even do one next weekend. I'm just gonna look at the corals and I'm going to let them tell me what they need. But I did notice the trace elements and all that in the salt. The accuracy one salt has really, my corals have responded really well to it, and I like it, man. It mixed super clear with no residue, no leftover salt, dirt, or anything in like 5 minutes. So, real quick question is about salt. It just popped to mind. I know this video is already long, but let me ask you guys. I run a chiller on this tank, and I usually always temperature match my water change water. You know, if it's in within a degree or 2 degrees, you know, I'm not going to big deal it, and I'll just do the water change. I'm guilty. So if you're going to knock me for that, I'm guilty. So, but my question is, I run a chiller on this tank, and this tank runs about 77 degrees 24/7. I know I can bump it up as high as 86. You know, I don't want to be that high. But my question is, because my tank temp is at 77, I noticed last week when I did my water change water that the water was 81, almost 82 degrees. Do you think I'm going to have any negative effects by dumping in water with the temperature, you know, 3-5 degrees higher than my tank? I mean, I know realistically I'm probably only going to be bumping up my tank temp by probably 2 degrees from wherever it's at. You know, mixing 82 degree in with 77 degree in, it's only 4.5 gallons. Total system volume is 30 actual gallons of water after rock displacement. I don't know, just something I was thinking about, like, should I be worried? And what are you guys saying? You guys think I should float some frozen water bottles in there to bring the temp down closer to 77? Like I said, it's been at 81, 82. I have it in my kitchen, my house temps. I haven't been running my AC. Just curious your thoughts. But, so there's your update video. I apologize for it being 40 minutes long. I'm not even going to edit this. I'm just going to post it up just to get it out there so you guys can check out the tank. Big shout out to the local reefers. I've been getting kind of involved with a lot of little projects with local reefers. I appreciate your guys' interest and getting me over there to help you out, putting me to work. You know, I appreciate the corals. I appreciate you guys helping me out, you know, with work. I am working right now, but anything on the side reef related, I am always down to help. Tank moves, breakdown setups, you know, whatever. And I just want to say thank you to the local reefers, to the community. I also want to say thanks to the fish fam, everybody that's been there from day one. Shout out to Dave. Hope you're doing great, man. Hope you're feeling better. I haven't heard any news about you. And just my family knows about your condition. We're all thinking and praying for you. And the fish fam misses you. Maybe we can just say hi. Let everybody let you know that we care and thank you. Like I said, I didn't know you too well, but you know, the streams that I was on were fun. They were awesome. So I just want you to know that we haven't forgot about you, and thank you for all you have done, and just wanted to say hi. Also shout out to all the big YouTubers out there. Hey, thanks for putting out the product videos, you know, the reviews, sharing, you know, all your awesome brand new equipment, walking us through, telling us your thoughts, reviews on it, just putting out your videos, the live streams when they get all crazy, the big YouTubers getting passionate, you know, I like seeing that. I think that's why a lot of people watch, is they want to see that passion, that, you know, that they want to see you get pissed off when, you know, people make stupid comments, and they want to see that passion. And I just want to say thanks for putting out that content. I enjoy watching it. I also enjoy the journey along with you guys and your tanks. You know, I like seeing the ups and downs, and I like you guys walking us through all the trade shows. A lot of us wish that we can go to these trade shows, but, you know, unfortunately money and all that, it's not an option. You know, we can't make it, it's too far. So I appreciate you guys putting out all that content. Like I said, all the brand new equipment, the reviews, taking us to the shows, showing us your own personal tanks, taking us around to local reefers tanks. That's pretty awesome. I think a couple guys have said, you know, we kind of all enjoy watching the videos, whether they, you know, apply to our own tanks or not. I think we all just enjoy seeing what other people are doing, other people's progress, what works, what doesn't work. We all kind of take that information and then get our own little way of doing things out of all that collected information. So thanks everybody for that. To all the guys that are uploading weekly, thank you for that. I don't want to name any names and miss anybody, so I just want to say thanks to the YouTube Fish Fam, to the local reefers. I just want to say I love you to my family, just in case something happens to me and they could come back and check out my videos. I love all you guys, and I appreciate you putting up with me in the hobby. I know that sometimes it can be frustrating with all the, you know, the reef junk that I like to call it, all my little gear all over the places, the water changes, the people coming over, the money spent, the time I spend helping others. I appreciate you guys understanding and supporting me in the hobby, and I love you guys, and just trying to keep it real, man. So thanks for watching, everybody. Let me know if you just want me to continue just giving updates, or if you want to do an in-depth walkthrough on any equipment, light schedules, maintenance, what kind of videos you guys want to see me put out. The tank is starting to mature more, and it's kicking off with color. It's starting to grow in. I want to say 4 months from now, this thing should be a nice little color palette to look at. Hopefully, you know, life doesn't kick me in the butt and everything on this tank continues to be on the right track. And if not, we're going to do what we got to do to battle those hard times. And you know what's up. So happy 4th of July again. Missed out on that. Thanks for everybody that was in the military. Thanks for, you know, taking care of our country and giving us that right to all that served. I just want to say thank you. Happy 4th of July to mothers, fathers, everybody, reefers, upcoming reefers, young reefers. What's up, man? You're the future. And thanks for sharing your journey, you know. And I think that's about all I got, man. I'm rambling. And not sure what to say. So thanks everyone once again. If you liked what you saw, if you guys hung out for this long, thank you. Please hit that like button. It seems like I get some views, but no one hits the like button. If you want to leave a comment, please leave a comment. If you want to tell me I'm a dumbass, tell me I'm a dumbass. Regardless, I appreciate everyone coming through. Love for love. Love everyone. Salt Squad in the house. Gonna go ahead and start some testing here, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Thanks for watching. Later.